Hey everybody, I'm Jordan, and it's day 7 of our Advent journey towards Christmas. I hope the stories we've been sharing have been inspiring and helpful to prepare your heart. They have been for mine as we head towards Christmas in this Advent season. Today we turn to the New Testament, to the life of Jesus for our text, and we're going to be looking at Matthew 14. Matthew 14 records the events, a crazy 24 hours in the life of Jesus. So many things are happening. He's just gotten the news that his cousin and close friend John has been murdered. And of course, he would want to grieve in that time. But as is typical for Jesus, he can't go anywhere without crowds following him. So at this point, the same thing happens. He tries to get away, but a whole crowd of people follows after him. And again, like Jesus always does, he has compassion on them. And he ends up feeding over 5,000 people with some miraculous signs, multiplying the fish and the loaves. And this is the way that this sets up our text for today. And so now I'll go on and read what it says from there. It starts in verse 22. Immediately after this, Jesus insisted that his disciples get back into the boat and cross to the other side of the lake. Well, he sent some people home. After sending them home, he went into the hills to pray by himself. Night fell while he was there alone. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from land, for a strong wind had risen and they were fighting heavy waves. At about 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came toward them walking on the water. When the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified. In fear, they cried out, "This is a ghost." But Jesus spoke to them at once. "Don't be afraid," he said. "Take courage. I'm here." Then Peter called to him, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you and walk on the water." "Yes, come," said Jesus. So Peter went over the side of the boat and walked on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and he began to sink. "Save me, Lord," he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out and grabbed him. "Have you so little faith?" Jesus said. "Why did you doubt me?" When they climbed back into the boat, the wind stopped, and the disciples worshipped him. "You really are the Son of God," they exclaimed. The disciples were in awe of Jesus, both coming to them on the water, but also calling Peter out of the boat. When was the last time that you were in awe of Jesus? What has he done in your life that just blows your mind and you can't believe it, but you're also drawn in to trust him more and more, and you're drawn to get out of the boat and walk towards him when he calls to you? What is it about Jesus in your life that makes you respond in worship and awe and love for all that he does for you? Oh, come, let us adore him in this Advent season.